God, and welcome to this exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. But we're talking about the joy of the Lord. Listen to this. The angel appeared in Luke chapter 2 to lowly shepherds. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. That's the question you must answer before we leave you this week. Where is this joy that the angel declared and prophesied that should come, to you by the entrance of the Son of God into your life? Where is this joy? He said, it's not just joy, but great joy. Why great joy? Because the Father has finally done something to bring the tyranny of Satan down, to nullify His power. Up until then, we were all helpless. Up until then, we had no prayer. Up until then, man couldn't return to heaven. We, even the righteous, went to paradise. It was great joy. Tidings. Do we even know why the angels were rejoicing? Isn't it a shame that you'd be thinking about what gift you didn't receive and you missed the joy? The angel said, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. Notice, to all people. It doesn't matter what your race is, your religion is. It doesn't matter. This is for the entire world. For unto you, it's a personal thing, unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior. Watch this. Which is Christ, the anointed one, the Lord. Hallelujah. Every knee must bow, beloved. Every tongue must confess that he is Lord. It will be unfortunate for you to do it after death. You better do it now. You better do it now. Ah, come on, beloved. He is Lord. I love that song. He is Lord. He is Lord, he is risen from the dead. He is Lord, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. That's the message, beloved. He said he is Christ the Lord. Nobody else comes close. When I see all the philosophies and people reading all these books and making noise, I say, beloved, you can never attain the reality of the presence of God except through Jesus Christ. It will be a sad day at death to discover that you've believed error, you've embraced this foolishness, and in our generation we are being told, don't preach the gospel. No, this is an era of accommodation. Don't offend anybody. How can somebody write a book saying what God said and he's suspended in this city of Atlanta and nobody has said a word? No bishop, no pastor, no apostle, nobody on television, nobody, no concerned clergy, nobody has come to his defense. How could it be? Are we that asleep? Are we that afraid? What is our problem? He is Lord, beloved. Sin is sin. Can't change it. I told you, those of you that flagged my video, I think you have stopped because you're going to get yourself in trouble. He is Lord. By him all things were created. He is Lord. Every knee will bow to him. Every tongue must confess. He is Lord. It's non-negotiable. You will either find it out on this earth by believing his preachers, or you'll find it at death, and it'll be too late. Hallelujah. He says, and this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace, goodwill to men. See? Glory to God in the highest. But on earth, peace, goodwill to men. So what does that tell you? It is his absence that's causing all the chaos and mayhem. Even in church, it is his absence. He may have the name Christian on the door, but if he is not Lord inside the sanctuary, there'll be chaos and mayhem in the family. He's the only reason there's no peace. He doesn't have his place in society, in government, in education. You must put him back. And then there'll be peace. There'll be goodwill. We'll go back to the days when you can correct children and discipline and teachers teach and the glory of God will be in the classroom and people can understand what is being taught. You can have devils all over the place and expect to succeed. Money will never solve it, beloved. You will bankrupt the nation and you can't solve it. No, you ignorant people that don't know the Lord. Carrying Bibles and claiming to be reverend, this and that, and you're the ones on TV that they bring in for these interviews, and you don't know the Lord. Come and get people like us that can tell you the truth. So you'll understand that he is Lord, that he is what's missing. The moment we humble ourselves before him, God said to me, do you know that if America would just shut down one day just to me, because of me, as Chick-fil-A will not open on Sundays. Just choose one day, and the whole nation shuts down. He said, I will reverse the curse in this nation. I will break the power of the devil. I'm telling you, I pray that you guys are listening. I pray that America, even you believers, are listening. I'm praying. God's not happy. He's been giving little warnings here and there, but he's getting to the danger zone. He is Lord. Nobody can change that verdict. It doesn't matter. Nobody. The time of judgment is just about here. But you will see for yourself. I'm going to be here preaching. And I said, didn't I tell you? This Boxing Day. Yes, box your gifts, but box the devil in. Box your pride in. Box your judgments in. Box your prejudices in. Box your depression in. And let the glory enter in and bless your life and strengthen you, and we can rejoice together. And we'll walk in the joy of the Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Go to church this Sunday. You've celebrated with your family. Come on. Get back in there. Let's serve God together. We love you. Bye-bye.